identical sign. There he is. Preparing the darkness. Okay, so for film's sake,
yeah.
I'm gonna ask you, how many times do you suppose that you've painted this building in this Texaco?
Probably take each year since 2009 and multiply by 3. So what would that be?
How many
three
years?
Over 6 years.
So how many times would that be?
18. I've done at least 18. At least 18.
But
at
each
least,
one
though,
is completely
no
different, correct? Like you never mimic the same picture. Like
not
you
exact,
always,
no.
You always change up your trucks and the flags
and the people.
The fish on top, which I'm going to like.
Yeah, the fish now, for instance, here, although it looks nice, it's an east wind, which the fishermen don't like. So it would be a lucky thing.
And it's funny, too, because the fishermen probably would notice that, right?
They would, yeah. They'd definitely notice it. They'd feel it. They'd notice it. They'd feel it. They'd feel it. Because it's, if you're a real fisherman, Roberta Morgan came by yesterday, and she says to me, well, her Jim, who's in the ring, doesn't feel good today. I said, it's the easterly wind. It's got him out of sorts.
Huh.
It's
so
all
they noticed.
Switched around. He's going to feel better.
So they notice.
I did. I think when you're in Menemsha, everything's fish. Fish stories.
Okay, so here's the thing too, right? So all the boats and all the, different background things that you put lettering into, have you ever misspelled something on a painting and had to redo it?
Yeah.
Anything like super blatant?
No, it's more like not leaving the right space. Right now, you can see what I'll do. Texaco has a little more space on this side, the sign does, so just make the sign a little smaller.
Nice. So you trim the sign down. And do you think that, and obviously I'm not an artist, so I don't want to insult you by using the wrong words, but when you do like the smudges where everything's raised up, do you think that that helps you when you need to fine tune it? It usually works on your side?
I would guess, yeah. I mean each mark, whether it's, it might seem random, but there's a kind of a continuity to the application.
Right, but as small as these are what, 10 by 12?
12 by 16.
Okay, so 12 by 16 is like you pack tons of detail into there, obviously. And when you do them, do you pencil them first or do you just start lining? So how long did this specific painting take you?
It would be of concerted effort, perhaps
say afternoons, are you talking 4 or 6 hours?
Well, 12 to 6, even 8 or 9 hours, being late. Then what are you talking about?
I know.
So there's that, we just, did you have that running through the whole place?
Yeah, it's running.
So,
so you would wait for it to dry and then you would fine-tune it even more?
I don't know. I think that it might be done completely, and when it's all dry, I'd rub down the high edges, and if I need to retouch it at that point, I would. But at the same time, I think it's important to
makes perfect sense too. Like a writer would do that as well. Like maybe write a story and then like revisit it. Yeah. Have you ever done like a really nice work of art and then like went to put it away and like drop it face down or like totally ruin like a good quality chunk of work?
That's a good question. It's an interesting question. It's not the most, not a common question, but it's probably a concern of artists or, you know, people who would see something created like this that's not precious, perhaps, in a way, and you put a lot of work on it, not want to. So, no, the quick answer is no. Some things that have happened to paintings, though, that haven't made a difference in the end, because either it's been corrected or it's incorporated into the painting, are getting sandblasted. So, in other words, I'm painting on the beach, and the painting, actually, the sand blowing, and it gets up in the air and onto the painting. And instead of trying to scrape it off and work it out, I'm working it into the painting. And then if any need it to be rubbed off and the after it's all dry, done that, and that's done.
But essentially they're like literally getting a piece of Menemsha, because not only do they get the art, but they have pieces of Menemsha like that. See, you can charge extra for the ones that like blow sand up onto them.
Another occasion, painting on Liberty Street. And I always anchor my paintings well, because it's New England and you just don't know when a wind might come up and blow the, you know, the easel over or whatever. Anyway, I had secured everything pretty well, except that I put the canvas on this boulder in a way that it was able to get knocked by the wind, fall forward, slide down in its holder, and then take off, hitting me on the head or shoulder as it flipped over my head in a busy intersection. In Newbury Street. So I turn as I'm watching the wind take my painting away. It's turning and flipping in the air and going across the street. And it was oncoming traffic. And I thought, oh no, now the painting is about to hit the deck and the light is changing and the car is completely over. As I'm watching the painting tumble across the side, crosswalk, I look and who's there but the director of the Botany Society and a friend of mine, and he ducks, puts his hands out, and catches a big red bird. And as I look at it, it's facing me.
That's impressive. Done? But you're going to revisit it. Very nice. Congratulations, you had yourself a painting. I like it. I'm going to try to do that. And you did a good job. Not your way, Andy.
Yeah.
Sorry. How often do I actually film all?